The Type 192, latest in the line of Bristol helicopters, is a heavy-duty tandem rotor aircraft powered by two Napier Gazelle gas turbine engines. It is capable of operating in many different military roles, among them troop and freight transport, search and rescue, ambulance, paratrooping and supply dropping. The use of gas turbine engines gives the Type 192 an exceptionally low level of external noise. Either of its engines can, in emergency, operate both rotors, and the helicopter is capable of taking off and cruising at maximum all-up weight on one engine. The Type 192 was the first helicopter in production in the world with true two-engine safety. The aircraft can cruise at speeds up to 140 miles an hour and can carry a payload of about 3 tons. The tandem rotor configuration is the basic feature of the 192's design. The gas turbine engines are located directly beneath each rotor. Under normal conditions, each engine delivers 980 shaft horsepower, but either is capable of an immediate and automatic increase to 1,650 shaft horsepower should the other engine fail. Here, the front engine intake is blanked off, and the aircraft is flying on the rear engine only. The fact that the power units are normally operating at only about 60% of maximum output gives gated engine performance. As a result, output is virtually constant up to an altitude of 7,000 feet. The engines are mechanically connected by a synchronizing shaft. This keeps the rotors in phase, and in the event of engine failure, enables one engine to do the work of two, to allow the rotors to overrun the engine in auto-rotation or single-engine flight. A free wheel is built into the transmission. Forerunner of the 192 was the piston engine Type 173. The 192 embodies the experience accumulated by Bristol in many years of helicopter design, production and operation. A number of its main components are basically similar to those proved in long service with the Sycamore. One example is the rotor head mechanism with its axle and spider system of flying control. Gearboxes on the two helicopter types also have many common features. The arrangement of gear wheels in the 192 main reduction gearbox, for instance, closely follows that of the Sycamore. Specialized helicopter test facilities have been designed and built by Bristol for development purposes. This is a test rig for ground testing of engines and transmissions. The company's helicopter rotor blade test tower at Filton was the first of its kind in the world. At Weston-super-Mare in Somerset, where Bristol helicopter design, development and manufacture are concentrated, the Type 192 is in quantity production for the Royal Air Force and will enter squadron service in 1960. Work in the helicopter division is backed by Bristol's considerable technical resources and by the knowledge and experience gained by the company in a half century of progress in many aeronautical fields. Production is organized on orthodox flow assembly lines, with components and sub-assemblies feeding into a final assembly stage. Design studies are being made of various civil derivatives, and this is a mock-up of a possible interior layout. Marked interest is being shown in the 192's potentialities as a civil helicopter operating on city centre to city centre services. Even before it entered service, the Type 192 had given impressive demonstrations of its capabilities. At the 1959 Farnborough show, the helicopter was one of the stars of the flying display. First, it landed and disembarked 18 fully armed troops. While this was going on, the aircraft was prepared for carrying an underslung load. The Type 192 moved away to pick up a Bristol Ferranti Bloodhound surface-to-air guided missile and its trolley, a load of about 2 tons. The operation, from touchdown to moving off with the Bloodhound, was completed in 30 seconds. Bloodhound is set down gently, and an automatic release speeds up disengagement of the load. With the permission of the Air Ministry, the 192 tackled an unusual crane operation on behalf of the Mullard Radio Astronomy Laboratory of the University of Cambridge. The load, a parabolic aerial for a radio telescope, weighed 2 tons. And drag in forward flight was estimated to impose an additional load of about the same amount. The aerial was too large to be moved by road intact and too delicate to be dismantled and re-erected. Only a heavy-duty helicopter like the 192 could possibly have undertaken this peculiar transport job. In less than 5 minutes, the aerial had been moved 6 miles to a new site where another radio telescope is already operating. In a large-scale army exercise on Salisbury Plain, the Type 192 gave convincing proof of its adaptability. It was first used as a personnel carrier, moving in units of the reserve. In one sortie, the aircraft carried a full load of passengers and freight. The troops travelled in the cabin, and the freight, medical supplies for a new casualty caring station, was carried in a netted load underslung from the strong point. There are no stowage problems when freight is carried by helicopter in this way, and much time is saved. Finally, the Type 192 made several flights evacuating stretcher cases and walking wounded. The casualties were landed near an advanced surgical center. Versatility is probably the greatest need in a military helicopter. And the Bristol Type 192 is one of the most versatile aircraft ever produced.